大家好, hello everyone. In this video, we just learned some Chinese language for several words, just several words. In this video, we will continue to learn Chinese language in this channel. But for this channel, not only this kind of videos, but also some others. Like shoes or some other things. So if you want to learn Chinese language, you can watch my video. 今天我们学的几个词，第一个叫渗透，渗透三点水一个餐，四声渗，透是走之底一个秀，渗透，从这个字的形状呢， from the shape of this word, this character, we can see that the first character there is on left side, there is 三点水,你看三点水,就表示这个字呢,往往它的意思跟水有关, means there is some relationship between water and this character, mean. 餐,眼肾,三点水,右边是个 餐跟肾这个发音上面比较相似啊, the pronounce between 餐 and 肾, they are similar. 所以三点水加一个餐就读肾, and 第二个 character 是透, 透走之底, 旁边一个秀, 你看他们的韵母都一样, 都是发O的音, 秀和透的韵母是一样的, 只是声母不同, 秀的声母是 这个音, 然后呢, 透的声母是 t这个音, 渗透, 那它的 tone, 它的音调是几声呢? 渗显然是四声, 四声啊, 渗渗渗渗，渗就是四声，透呢也是四声，透透透透，这里读透，所以它是四声，渗透，它的英文意思就是 penetration， 对应的英文意思是 penetration， penetration， p e n e penetration， t r a t i o n。 Obviously, the English words is a lot more easier to learn, huh? Because you can spell it. When you see this word, you can spell it, then you can pronounce it. So it's a lot more easier. But Chinese language, it's so much more difficult. From the character, every character is like a little picture. Right? It's like a little picture, so if you don't know how to pronounce, you just don't know. You have to remember them. You cannot spell them. 渗透, you can only remember them. Then you have to repeatedly to speak it or write it. But for the English, penetration, it's a lot more easier. As long as you remember how to pronounce, mostly you can write it. And if you can write it, mostly you can just pronounce it. So that's a lot more simple. Okay. Next word, 浸润。浸润, 三点水, 跟侵略的侵那个字儿很相似。 浸润，这俩字都带三点水，因为都跟水有关。浸润，它的英文意思是 infiltration，infiltration， I N F I L T R A T I O N， infiltration， 浸润，浸润，带水的这个意思，浸润，这个浸这个。 字如果跟别的字组合呢，又可以变成别的词语，比如说浸泡啊， 沉静啊，什么什么的啊，就是他一个 character，他跟不同的 character 组合在一起，就可以组成不同意思的词。这就是汉语，意思是 infiltration。好，下一个词，熏陶，熏陶。下边一个黑，黑的是那一竖中间那个竖那个轴伸出来一点儿，然后在上面呢再加一个长横。长横上面那根竖伸的再出来一点点，上面再加一个小撇，那就读熏。完了，桃字儿呢是一个双关耳，然后桃啊那样写的熏陶。英语的意思就是 influence，熏陶。好，我们今天就学这三个词啊，欢迎收看下期节目，我们接着学。